Sons of God, listen to the statements I'm going to make.
Lalelani ke nakulenda kusho basalwa.
And we are not hearing a man who's telling you things that I learned from Bible College.
Anilalele kumdulo kulumatino jela tfunze college.
Please.
Ngakela.
Life is warfare.
Impilo yimpi.
Never reduce yourself to a beggar.
Ungatehliseleke wena sibusibeke esigabeni sekucela.
Refuse to beg for help.
Yala khamba ucela lusito.
Instead become a giver of help.
Kunaloko yiba ngiloneketa lusito.
Because we are a champion.
Ngoba ungishampene.
Did you what I've said?
Nivile ngicela.
Your life must be clear.
Impilo yakho kufuna icace.
Ask your neighbor for me now. What are you alive for?
Uthi uphilelani wena?
Oxygen waster.
Wena locetha umoya.
No one was born to spectate the success of others. We all possess the same number of brain cells. Two ears, two eyes. One big mouth. To get your attention. If the people who are more successful than you, who drive nice cars, who are loaded in the bank, had 4 feet, I was going to excuse you. 4 eyes, I was going to excuse you. Tell your neighbor, be careful how you look at me. We are the same. Different results. But by design, you are a champion. Are you understanding me? We possess the likeness of God. We possess the image of God. We possess the qualities of God. No one was created by Papa God to be a perpetual sufferer. That devil must leave you alone. Rise to your feet and say, I will make it. Whether the devil likes it or not. Hey, I'm pumping you. Because you are loaded on the inside. But you allow the outside circumstances to reduce you. Say, not after today. Listen to me. God will not make you successful. He will help you to succeed through His word, through the Holy Spirit, through preachers. Full stop. But the producer of the success is you. Point at yourself and say, me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are responsible. This is a big one. This is what you must hate from today. Even if you'll forget all the sermons. Don't forget this. There's one demon you must hate. It's called the demon of failure. This is one demon you must hate. And I want you to start being angry now. And even start sweating with anger. Now, I want the sweat to begin now. The spirit of failure. How can you be content and happy and okay? When people that you grew up with, went to school with, live in the same environment with, their lives are far from yours, and you look okay. Who bewitched you? You must be restless. You are alive, your life is not moving, and you are okay. A Christian is a hustler. A Christian is a producer of success by force. Why? Because your success must advertise Jesus. A Christian is a go-getter. Did I talk to you? Lift up your hand and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I officially announce today that failure is my number one enemy. I will fight failure until it is replaced with amazing success, so that your name is glorified. Pray. How do you think you'll attract your relatives, people to Jesus with that life that is struggling? You will not rest, my dear. You will fight until you break through. Lambroka, open your mouth and pray. You'll fight. Brothers and sisters, I hope someone heard me. Because naturally you'll discover that you are trying and things are not opening up.
Yeah.
Go deep into prayer. Wrestle with the heavens. Are you understanding me? Wrestle with circumstances. Never get tired of declaring that I can't remain in this condition. Things must change. And in this kingdom, change is produced on your knees.
Hallelujah.
Not in complaining. If you don't want to be a slave of suffering, be a slave of three things. One, write it down, prayer. Be a slave. Don't pray this prayer way you are praying. Even after you finish praying, your face look normal. You think if Hannah had a normal face while she was praying, Samuel was going to come. You come out messed up. You lie on the floor and say to God, if you don't come through for me, who else will help me? There are prayers God listens to, and there are prayers He doesn't listen to. Some people are suffering because they are not crying for themselves enough to God. They waste energy complaining to people, telling people about their problems. I saw a verse in Isaiah 62:7. Am I the only one who saw it? You never give yourself rest in prayer as long as things are not moving. The verse is there. Until God establishes you in the glorious life you desire, there's no rest for you. Be a slave of looking for destiny helpers is number three. You think I would be where I am if it was just me and God? God uses people to connect you to the things you want. Put your pride aside. Look for those who have broken through in the area of your pursuit. Forget about the jealousy. Are you hearing me? How can you call yourself a preacher? You are called by God, but you never sit down in front of mentors so that they polish you and even give you what is called pulpit etiquette. Because you must know that on this pulpit you cannot climb with shoes that are not polished or tired. Are you understanding me? You never climb the pulpit with a tired shirt and a twisted tie. When you climb the pulpit, you have already worked on your display. Because remember, you are representing a God who loves Himself. He told Aaron in Exodus 28, he told Moses, he says, those priests, get skilled tailors. They must make for them garments that are dignified, so that when they stand before the people will see they represent the majestic God of heaven. We don't dress nice because we are proud. It's a standard of this kingdom. You cannot come on the pulpit with your tired suit.
Jesus.
Write it down. You work hard towards connecting yourself with people who will polish you. I'm a pastor that is polished all the time. I was not like this when God called me. I heard the calling, but I was a chaos. Chaotic cold one. You will not be polished by God. You will be polished by those who who have succeeded in your area of pursuit. Whatever you want to do, look for them until you get them. They are called destiny helpers, bridges to where you want to reach. I've got them in different nations of Israel. They are on my WhatsApp. If you only try to get solutions from God, you'll be a holy sufferer. You love God, but things are not moving. If your friends are people who are like you, excuse me, you are not going anywhere. I'm so sorry. Let's read this word, then I'm going to conclude. Philippians 3:13-14. Fight for your success. Tell your neighbor, please fight for your success. It's a fight. It's what? It's a fight. It's a fight. I always say to ladies, if a boyfriend rejects you, or you become divorced by a man, the only way to revenge is not to be angry, is to succeed until he feels ashamed. Is to succeed until he regrets.
He will hear that you went to
his mother
and gave it to his mother, a big grocer.
The best way to revenge is massive success that will leave your enemies worried. Let's read it. Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself. Are we reading now? I'm now concluding the matter. I do not consider myself to have taken hold of it. But one thing I do, there are things you need to do. I forget what is behind and strain towards what is ahead. I press on towards the goal. Press on. Listen to the big word. Press on. All the things that you desire, whether you want a new job, you want to get better money coming into your business, you want to grow spiritually and become an impactful Christian, you want your life to be an attraction, these things will not just happen. Someone must press on. Press on. Things are tough, but you don't give up. Things are delaying, but you keep on pushing. Listen to me, you cannot apply average effort and get extraordinary results. Write it down. Extraordinary effort. I once made a statement in this church. I said, if they hire you in a company, or we give you a position in the church, it must be just like in the story of Jesus.
Jesus entered and it was hell.
Don't be a pastor in a church. You are leading a department in the church. But
it's like you're not there. You are even reminded.
Jesus
Christ.
Wherever you are placed, aim to be a game changer.
Things must change because you have arrived.
You have that mindset. Say thank you, Jesus. Write these following things, then we pray. Number one, press on. Wake up every morning to pray without ceasing for yourself, for your family, for the church, for sinners, and for the nation. The Bible says pray without ceasing. This life will never favor you as a Christian if you don't pray for yourself, pray for your family, pray for your church, pray for sinners, and pray for the nation. Life will reject you. Press on to these things. Number two, wake up every morning to go to work or to business. Don't tell me, Pastor, I can't find a job. Just leave me alone with that excuse. If you can't find a job, you find work. What is work? Services you can offer, products you can sell, because life is about exchange. As long as people get nothing from you, money will not come to you, even if you can pray in capital letters. Did you hear what I've said? You wake up every morning. This is as per Matthew 7:7. In the Amplified, the words are in red in the Bible. Jesus himself said it. He said, ask and keep on asking. In the Amplified, seek and keep on seeking. Knock and keep on knocking. When we are a Christian, there are things we have to keep on doing until you break through to where you are supposed to be. There's no time to lazy around. Can I talk to somebody here? No time to lazy around. If you are clapping for Jesus, those who are students, you wake up every day to educate yourself, acquire new skills, so that you will end up getting that good job that will pay you your own money and stop eating your mother's bread and food. Press on to these things. Are you hearing me?
Never in.
The retired elderly people, let me see bo gogo le seba retired. All the retired gogos.
Le seba penchele bo gogo.
Your assignment is simple.
Umsebenzi wenu lula.
It's not to go around crying asking for money because we are gogo.
Akusiko hamba nicela imali ngoba ungogo.
You must read your Bible.
Fundzani Bible le.
Timothy had a gogo.
Na Timothy abena
gogo. That gogo helped that young man to become the strong evangelist we read about. As an elderly person, it's too late for you now to be running up and down doing all other things. You need to pray for the success of your children, the success of your grandchildren, so that you are supported by children who came out of your womb. Say, press on. Number five, what do you wake up to do? You wake up to go and hunt for new opportunities. This one you must write. You wake up to go and hunt for new opportunities and craft new ideas. It means as you are seated here, a new week is starting tomorrow. It's a week of hunting for opportunities. It's a week of crafting new ideas, because the money that comes into your life, you are responsible for ensuring that it never runs out. One, it keeps on increasing. Two, prayer will never do it for you. Hello. Did you hear what I've said? You wake up every day. If you are going to be retiring at 60, there's already a clear plan. How will my life be sustained financially until Jesus calls me home? If you don't plan, you don't keep on hunting for new opportunities, you are set to crash. And God will not help you. Rise to your feet. I'm going to give you the last one. Then we pray. As a Christian, you press on. You wake up to keep on looking for people that you can bring to church week after week to earn what is called the soul winner's crown. Write that one down. Soul winner's crown. Soul winner's crown. Two things you must never fail to win. Keep on winning and getting money for yourself. Keep on winning and getting people for Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Lift up your hands unto heaven. I want you to pray so strong. Pray like you have never prayed. Say, Father, as I finish this service, I pray the prayer of Jabez. 1 Chronicles 4:10. God bless me, please. Bless me indeed. Make me an impactful person. Make me, O God, to be a person who produces amazing results. May I never be a beggar. May I never be angry at other people because of money issues. May I make my own money because I'm born of God now. I have all it takes to succeed in this life. In the name of Jesus, say, Father, plant in me a new anger, new hatred for failure and poverty and mediocrity in the name of Jesus. Say, Father, I declare that as I leave the service, I'm going out to produce results in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. May the Lord help you to press on, never to give up, to give yourself wholly, completely towards pursuing your dreams, your goals, refusing every day to be slowed down, to be reduced. May your life produce the kind of success that will cause people to respect your God. In Jesus' name. Clap those hands for the Lord. Clap those hands for the Lord. Amen.